بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. We continue inshallah the discussion on the belief and the pre-decree, the six pillar of Iman. We discussed last night the ranks of Al-Qadr per training to Allah's knowledge, and also per training to Allah's writing and the levels of writing, which we discussed. Also, we started with the Mashi'a, the will of Allah. Now we're gonna inshallah know that the Mashi'a of Allah, the divine decree of Allah, is either universal, kawniyya, and I put those on text, in text for you inshallah to copy. If you can screen up the screen, if you scan it, go up and you will find it inshallah. So the Mashi'a, the will of Allah, na'am, is first the universal, which is called al-kawniyya, al-kawniyya, and the other is the legal, judicial, or shar'iyya. Okay, the first one, al-irada al-kawniyya, the universal will, is the will of Allah in which his intention is carried out. Okay, his intention is carried out in relation to his creation. It is not necessary that what is carried out by his creation is liked by him subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not necessary. He however willed it to pass. This is known as the universal will or the al-kawniyya. For example, Allah created Satan, the devil, shaitan, wal-ayyadu billah, yet he hates him. So his will passed, Allah's will passed in the creation of Satan. Okay, but Allah hates him. This is one example. The second example, Allah created the kuffar, the disbeliever, and he hates them. He created many things also that he loves. So whatever he permitted to exist, therefore, from disbelief, from belief, from obedience or disobedience, is related to this universal will, whether he loves it or not. Whether he loves it or not, he created it. He created it. This is called al-irada al-kawniyya or al-mashi'a al-kawniyya, the universal will of Allah. Simply, the universal will of Allah is related to his creation. So Allah, he creates what he wills, whether he likes it or whether he dislikes it, subhanahu wa ta'ala, he chose to let it pass, to come to existence. This is called the universal will. This is called the universal will. Under this will, Allah may decree to pass things which he does not command his slaves to follow. Allah may create or pass things which he does not command his slaves to follow. Example, kufr and disobedience. Allah created kufr and disobedience. No one can rebel against his universal will. No one can rebel against the universal will of Allah. This universal will of Allah is to pass. Okay. On the other hand, now we come to the judicial will or al-irada al-shar'iyya, the legislative will or judicial will, which is related to Allah's legislation. It's related to Allah's sharia. Hence, it is related to what Allah loves and likes, whether it takes place or not. This is important. Okay, all of his legislations, Allah loves it and likes it, whether it takes place or not, because there are those who will obey his legislation and those who will rebel against it. It is also known, now for example, the acts of obedience from the angels, from the prophets, and from the believers, when they take place, Allah loved, these are loved by Allah and are passed by his, and are passed by his universal will. Okay, under his judicial will, however, it's not necessary that his commands will be executed, because there are those who will rebel against his judicial commands. So under this aspect of the al-irada al-shar'iyya, it does not entail the execution of his wish subhanahu wa ta'ala. What Allah loves and is pleased with is related to his judicial commands, that is, he loves them to be executed as he demands. The linkage between the two now, the linkage between his universal will and his Sharia will, legislative will or judicial will, is clear in the following verse. Here it is for you to remember, inshallah, because it's very important. Okay, so I will try to summarize, inshallah. We are discussing now the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the will of Allah is divided into two kinds. The first one is the universal will. The universal will. And the universal will relates to his creation. Meaning, Allah creates what he wills, even if he dislikes. For example, in this case, Allah created Satan, yet he hates him. Allah created the disbelievers, and he hates them. He created many things that also he loves. So whatever Allah permitted to exist, therefore, falls under his universal will. This is the first kind. The other kind is the judicial will or legislative will. And this is related to what Allah loves and likes, whether it will take place or not. For example, the acts of obedience from the angels, from the prophets, from the believers, when they take place, they are loved by Allah, and Allah willed them to pass by his universal will. So in this case, acts of obedience, when they take place, comprise both wills of Allah. First of all, Allah willed them to pass, therefore they exist, and this pertains to his universal will. And he loves them, and this relates to his Sharia will, which means his legislation is being obeyed, and he likes that, and he loves that. But under this legislative will, it is not necessary that his commands would be executed, because there are those who rebel against Allah's judicial commands. Now, the linkage between the two wills, the Kawniya universal and Shar'iyya legislative wills, is in the following verse, Quran 40 verse 7, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا يَرْضَى لِعِبَادِهِ الْكُفْرِ وَلَا يَرْضَى لِعِبَادِهِ الْكُفْرِ. And he likes not كفر. For his slaves, and he, Allah, likes not kufr, disbelief. Chapter 39. There's wrong here. I'm sorry, I misquoted the ayah. It should be 39. I'm sorry. This is it, inshallah. This is the correct one. 39 instead of 40, verse 7. Surah Az-Zumar, Allah says, وَلَا يَرْضَى لِعِبَادِهِ الْكُفْرِ, and he likes not kufr, disbelief, for his slaves. It's obvious that Allah does not like or love disbelief, yet it exists. So, it exists that Allah does not like it. He does not like it. It deals with which type of will, since he does not like it. It deals with his legislative or judicial will. It is linked to his universal will by the fact that Allah willed for kufr to take place. Okay, he willed for disbelief to take place. What he likes or loves is different. What he likes and loves, what is different from his, this universal will of his. So Allah, let's go for this verse again. It's obvious that Allah does not like kufr. Okay. He does not like disbelief for his slaves. Yet disbelief exists. It's existing because of what? Because of his universal will, meaning Allah willed it to exist and created it. Alright? Yet he subhanahu wa ta'ala does not like kufr, does not like disbelief for his slaves. So this verse comprises both yarda, meaning pleased with. Now, so that the true believer follows, does not dispute, and submits to the legislative will of Allah. This is the right of the legislative will upon every slave of Allah. as far as the universal will, the slave of Allah has caught, has the right to quote face the decreed matters with other decreed matters. To understand these words, examine the response of Umar ibn al-Khattab, the companion of the Prophet ﷺ, when he was blamed for deciding not to enter the greater Syria land because of a sudden outbreak of plague, the disease, the plague, al-ta'un. He was told, are you running away from something which Allah had ordained? Okay. Umar didn't want to go to Ash-Sham, the greater Syria, because it was inflicted with the break or the outbreak of plague. You know plague. He was told, are you running away from something which Allah had ordained? Umar said, yes, we run away from what Allah has ordained, in this case the plague, to another thing which Allah had ordained. If someone is touched by hunger, thirst or cold, all of which are preordained by Allah, all are from the pre-decree, his response would be to eat, drink and put on clothes, thus checking the pre-decree with the pre-decree to the best of his ability. He checks the fire with water or soil until it is extinguished. He extinguishes the pre-decree of Allah, which is fire now, with the pre-decree of Allah, which is water. Similarly, with illness, he checks it with another pre-ordinance, which is medicine. And if an enemy of Islam plots against it, then it's by the pre-decree of Allah. It is incumbent, however, on every Muslim to check this pre-decree with another pre-decree which Allah loves. And it is the jihad by the hand or by spending wealth. So, meaning that these ordinances, these pre-ordinances are decreed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we are commanded to check them with each other. You know, the fire with water, the illness with the medicine. There remains the case where the divine decree is to pass and it cannot be checked. There remains the case, however, where the divine decree is to pass and it cannot be checked. The slave of Allah must totally submit and recognize the might of Allah in his ruling, in his justice, that this decree is just, and that wisdom, all the wisdom of Allah is behind his decision. Thus, whatever befalls him is not to miss him, and whatever missed him is not to befall him. All is in accordance with Allah's names and lofty attributes. Allah deserves the best praise from his slave who must search for his own ignorance, his sins and mistakes. This matter is clarified in four verses in the Quran. The first verse in chapter 4, verse 79. مَا أَصَابَكَ مِنْ حَسَنَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ وَمَا أَصَابَكَ مِنْ سَيِّئَةٍ فَمِنْ نَفْسِكَ. Whatever of good reaches you, victory, provisions, sound state of self and mind, etc., is from Allah. But whatever of calamities, fear, stress, illness befalls you is from yourself, is from yourself. The second verse, in chapter 3, verse 165. What is the matter with you when a single disaster smites you? Although you smote your enemies with one twice as great, you say, from where does this come to us? Say to them, it is from yourselves because of your evil deeds, and Allah has power over all things. The third ayah. I will discuss them all together, inshallah, shortly. 42, 30. وَمَا أَصَابَكُمْ مِنْ مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ وَيَعْفُ عَنْ كَثِيرٍ. And whatever of misfortune befalls you, it is because of what your hands have earned. The fourth verse, also, chapter 42, verse 48. And verily, when we cause man to taste of mercy from us, he rejoices thereat. But when some ill befalls them because of their deeds, which their hands have sent forth, then verily man becomes ingrate. Allah the Exalted clarified that misfortunes and calamities are linked to their causes. This is the point. Allah is pointing in these verses and clarifying that misfortunes and calamities are linked to their causes from the evil deeds and wrongdoings. Allah had decreed that calamities befall someone because of his wrongdoings. However, what reaches man of good, its causes are limitless. The favor of Allah will be in response to the action of his slave, or due to some other work that the slave did not do. It is incumbent, therefore, on the slave of Allah to give proper thanks to Allah and praise Him properly. The slaves of Allah should also seek forgiveness and repentance because of their own sinful deeds. Both misfortunes and favors are from the pre-decree of Allah. Both misfortunes and favors are from the pre-decree of Allah. They do not escape His will. They do not escape His will. قُلْ كُلٌّ مِّنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ فَمَا لِهَٰؤُلَاءِ الْقَوْمِ لَا يَكَادُونَ يَفْقَهُونَ حَدِيثًا. Say, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, all things are from Allah, so what is wrong with these people that they fail to understand any word? As in Surah An-Nisa 70. So, misfortunes and calamities are linked to their causes from the evil deeds and wrongdoings. And they befall and had been pre-decreed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I will repeat this segment, that these four verses that were put up there on the screen, Allah the Exalted clarified that misfortunes and calamities are linked to their causes from the evil deeds and wrongdoings. Allah had decreed that calamities befall someone because of his wrongdoings. However, what reaches man of good, its causes are limitless. The favor of Allah will be in response to the action of his slave or due to some other work that the slave did not do. It is incumbent, therefore, on the slave of Allah to give proper thanks to him and praise him properly. The slaves of Allah should also seek forgiveness and repentance because of their sinful deeds. Both, we should try with something of fear and hunger and loss of wealth and lives and crops, but give gladness to the fasting. Both these of trials are pre-decreed by Allah. Both are pre-decreed by Allah, but they are linked to their causes. They are also linked to their causes. Both misfortunes and favors are from the pre-decree of Allah, meaning that they don't escape His will. They don't escape His will. Okay? So as Allah said, قُلْ كُلٌّ مِّنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ. Say, O Muhammad, all things are from Allah. So what is wrong with these people that they fail to understand any word? Okay, Marjan. Allah says, whatever of evil befalls you is from yourself. Meaning, now, this is a case. If all matters are predestined, then how can we explain the verse, وَمَا أَصَابَكَ مِنْ سَيِّئَةٍ فَمِنْ نَفْسِكَ. Whatever of evil befalls you is from yourself. If all matters are pre-decreed, then how do we explain this verse? This is your question. This verse, وَمَا أَصَابَكَ مِنْ سَيِّئَةٍ فَمِنْ نَفْسِكَ, the ayah in its full text is as follows. مَا أَصَابَكَ مِنْ حَسَنَةٍ فَمِنْ اللَّهِ وَمَا أَصَابَكَ مِنْ سَيِّئَةٍ فَمِنْ نَفْسِكَ وَأَرْسَلْنَاكَ لِلنَّاسِ كَافَّةً وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ شَهِيدًا. Whatever good or man happens to you is from Allah. But whatever of evil befalls you is from yourself. And we have sent you, O Muhammad, as a messenger to mankind, and Allah is sufficient as a witness. The good and evil that... Now, I didn't start explaining it. You have to wait, Marjan, please. Could you wait a little bit to follow up with us? Now, go to this chapter, to this verse, Quran 4, verse 79, and try to follow with us, inshallah. And don't just just wait a little bit. This subject started last night, and so there are certain things that you missed, but I'm trying even to the ayah is in chapter 4 verse 79. Someone can put it, inshallah. وَمَا أَصَابَكَ مِنْ حَسَنَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ وَمَا أَصَابَكَ مِنْ سَيِّئَةٍ فَمِنْ نَفْسِكَ وَأَرْسَلْنَاكَ لِلنَّاسِ كَافَّةً وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ شَهِيدًا. Whatever good or man happens to you is from Allah, but whatever of evil befalls you is from yourself. and we have sent you, O Muhammad, as a messenger to mankind, and Allah is sufficient as a witness. This is chapter 4. Let me put it for you. You are giving so much questions, Yaakhi. Are you want the answer for the question that you raised, or you are coming now? Are you organized group and stuff like this? If you are willing to learn, you are welcome here. But these questions is not going to help you. The book, I can give you the name of the book. And this book is on online, so you can, inshallah, refer to it. This is the title of the book. Okay, let's go now, so let's discuss the question that you raised. The good and evil mentioned in this ayah do not refer to acts of obedience or disobedience respectively. The good here represents Allah's favors, like provisions, victory, good health, and so forth. The evil, on the other hand, represents calamities like fear, illness, earthquakes. Okay? This is what meant in this in this verse. Also, we read in chapter 3, to put all things in perspective, inshallah, 120. إن تصبكم حسنة تسؤهم وإن تصبكم سيئة يفرح بها وإن تصبروا وتتقوا لا يضركم كيدهم شيئا. If good befalls you, it grieves them, but if some evil overtakes you, they rejoice at it. But if you remain patient and pious, not the least harm will their cunning do to you. Surely Allah surrounds all that they do. Also, in chapter 7, verse 168, you will find also similarly, وَبَلَوْنَاهُمْ بِالْحَسَنَاتِ وَالسَّيِّئَاتِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. And we have tried them with good prosperity and blessings, and evil with calamities and adversities, in order that they might return to Allah's disobedience. So both calamities and blessings do not escape the will of Allah. This is what we are explaining here. They do not escape the will of Allah. Allah made this matter clear to the hypocrites at the time of the Prophet ﷺ, who acknowledged that the blessings are from Allah, but then accused the Prophet ﷺ of being the cause for whatever overtook them from adversity. Listen to what Allah said in this regard. وَإِن تُصِبْهُمْ حَسَنَةٌ يَقُولُ هَذِهِ مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ وَإِن تُصِبْهُمْ سَيِّئَةٌ يَقُولُ هَذِهِ مِنْ عِنْدِكَ قُلْ كُلٌّ مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ فَمَا لِهَؤُلَاءِ الْقَوْمِ لَا يَكَادُونَ يَفْقَهُونَ حَدِيثًا. If some good befalls them, they say, this is from Allah. But if some evil befalls them, then they say, this is from you, O Muhammad. Then the response of Allah was, say, O Muhammad, all things are from Allah. So what is the matter with these people that they fail to understand any word? The causes behind these calamities lie in the sin committed. This is the point, Marjan. The causes behind these calamities lie in the sin committed. The calamities and blessings are actions of Allah. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala signifies, quote, whatever good befalls you, and put befalls with bold letters or underline it. Whatever good befalls you, and whatever evil befalls them. No one says whatever befalls on me from acts of obedience or disobedience, because these matters are actions done by man himself. And that is why people say, I did an act of obedience or disobedience, and he names it. You see the difference between the two? Although both the blessings and calamities are preordained to occur, the occurrence of calamities has been linked to the sins committed by the slaves of Allah. The causes behind the occurrence of good are limitless. You see the point? The causes behind the occurrence of good are limitless, because it's a favor of Allah. It may occur because of one's deeds or without them. It is incumbent, therefore, that the slave of Allah gives the due thanks and praises to Allah, as well as seek his forgiveness from all sins. I hope, inshallah, this is clear to you. So we continue, inshallah, then with the subject. This addresses the question that you raised. So in summary, the divine decree of Allah. Those who missed the first part, the divine decree is divided into two: kawniya, universal, and this relates to Allah's creation. He passes what He wills. It is not necessary that He likes what He creates. It is not necessary that He likes what He creates or what is being carried out. He passes what He wills according to His universal will. It is not necessary that He likes what He creates or what is being carried out. Shaitan, devil, is created, and Allah hates him and his followers. He hates and dislikes their deeds too. It's taking place because He willed it. Allah willed it to pass. He does not command His slaves to follow what He dislikes. No creature can escape this universal will of Allah, that Allah willed these things to happen and to occur. No creature can escape this universal will of Allah. This is the universal of Allah. Now let's take, and we'll give examples inshallah more and more. Let's take the judicial will of Allah. The second type of will is the judicial will of Allah. This is related to Allah's legislation. This is related to Allah's legislation, meaning to His commands and ordinances. And this is only what He loves and likes, subhanallah. Allah loves His sharia. He likes to be obeyed. Okay. It does not necessarily, however, entail the execution of His desire. I mean, Allah commands, Allah sets the sharia, but it is does not necessarily entail the execution of His desire, because there are those who rebel against His sharia. His legislative commands are rebelled against by the kuffar and by the disobedient ones. He loves righteousness, but not everyone complies. So this is the sharia will. This is the al-irada al-shar'iyya. This is the legislative will of Allah, that Allah has pre-ordinances, commands and ordinances. He loves them to be executed. He likes them. He likes His sharia, but it is not necessary that this will be executed by the creation. Some may obey, some may disobey. I hope inshallah for the brothers and sisters that this is this distinction between the two is clear. Let's take some examples. The existing acts of obedience. Let's take case one. Existing, let's write them down here. The existing acts of disobedience. Now let me ask you a question now. Did Allah will them to pass? Marjan, I would like you to is the creature hated, or the choices and actions that the creature is responsible for? Allah, the creature, you have to define the creature who is hated. Allah hates the disbelievers and hates their actions, period. Allah loves the believers and loves their actions, period. So this responds to your question. Now let's take this first thing, the existing acts of disobedience. Now, yes, of course, Allah dislikes disobedience and Allah dislikes sin. It's correct. It's correct, ya Marjan. Let's take the existing acts of disobedience. Now, according to Allah's universal will, He willed them to pass. He willed them. Inshallah, you understand that, okay? Yeah, this is a general statement, but it's true. Allah's actions are different from the creature's actions, and they are distinct. But I would, let's take the existing acts of disobedience and try to follow with us, inshallah, brother or sister Marjan, brother or sister. Excuse me, let me have some water here and be back. So the existing acts of obedience, Allah willed them to pass, okay? The existing acts of obedience, Allah willed them to pass, and He loves them. You see, this is the point. Existing acts of obedience, existing acts of obedience, He, Allah, willed them to pass, and He loves them. This is first. Now, non-existing. Non-existing acts of obedience. Let me ask Sister Halima. The non-existing acts of obedience, Allah willed them not to pass or not? I will repeat. The non-existing, okay, the non-existing acts of obedience, those which did not occur, Allah willed them not to pass or not? Okay, I'll put the put it here to help you. Allah willed them not to pass. Say they are non-existing acts of obedience. Allah willed them not to pass. See, they are non-existing acts of obedience. Allah did not will them, therefore, to pass from His universal will. According to His universal will, Allah did not will them to pass. Allah will them not to pass. Now, does Allah love them or not? Does Allah love them or not? They are acts of obedience, but they didn't take place, okay? Allah willed them not to take place. Does He love them or not? Now, I will repeat. They are acts of obedience, not disobedience, huh? But they did not pass. Allah did not will them to pass. But He loves them, because Allah loves obedience. Allah loves obedience. Okay, so He loves them. You can look at it this way. Existing acts of obedience and non-existing acts of obedience, they are under the universal will of Allah. Either He will pass in case of those that it will exist and He will love them, and He will not let the others pass if they, you know, the non-existing ones, and He will love them because they are both acts of obedience. They are both acts of obedience. If it takes a place, this means He willed it to pass and He loves it. If it did not take place, the act of obedience, this means He did not will it to pass, but He loves it. Because Allah loves, according to His judicial will, loves all acts of obedience. Now we go to the other thing. Acts of kufr and disbelief. Acts of kufr and disbelief. What do you think about this? What do you think about this? Acts of kufr and disbelief. Allah willed them to pass or not? The occurring acts of disbelief now. Allah willed them to pass or not?
Baba?
Hmm?
Baba, Mom.
Okay. Okay. So Allah?
Baba?
Okay. Existing acts of kufr and disbelief, Allah willed them to pass. Allah willed them to pass. Yes. Yes, they are saying, yes. This is the daughter. She's a year and a half. She's a year and a half and she wants me to come for the dinner, she said. Okay. And... So let's finish this part, inshallah, and we'll take a break for 10 minutes and we will be back. So let's finish this. Existing acts of kufr and disbelief. Allah willed them to pass, certainly. Because they wouldn't exist that, you know, unless Allah permitted them to exist. So Allah willed them to pass. But does He like them? Here's the question. Does He like the acts of kufr and disbelief? No, exactly. Alright, now, the acts of kufr and disbelief that did not take place, that are not existing, the acts of kufr and disbelief that did not exist, it means that Allah did not will them to pass, did not will them to occur, and He also does not like them, and He also does not like them. So now we understand, inshallah, the universal will is related to whether Allah will let something to pass or not to pass, to occur or not to occur. Alright, now with respect to the legislative will, the command of Allah, the legislative will, He loves acts of obedience and He dislikes acts of disobedience. You understand now? Acts of obedience that He likes, He willed them to pass. And also the acts of disobedience, He disliked them, but He willed them also to pass. And most vividly is this in the creation of Shaitan. Allah hates him and hates his followers, but He willed that Shaitan be created and be found. And all it pertains to His knowledge, and all pertains to His wisdom and justice. So both the universal will of Allah and the legislative will of Allah are part of Allah's wisdom. Everything He performs in the universe or judicial commands His slaves to do, or He commands His slaves to do, is for a good reason and according to His wisdom, whether we are able to comprehend them or not. Allah says about Himself, أَلَيْسَ اللَّهُ بِأَحْكَمِ الْحَاكِمِينَ, is not Allah the best of judges? Allah loves those who do good, act justly, and follow His way. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ. Yes. Say, O Muhammad, if you really love Allah, then follow me, follow my teachings of the Quran and Sunnah, and Allah will love you. Okay? So Allah loves those good deeds. Allah likes what He prescribed of good deeds and sayings, and He dislikes what He prohibited of bad deeds and sayings. Allah says in this respect, إِن تَكْفُرُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ عَنْكُمْ وَلَا يَرْضَى لِعِبَادِهِ الْكُفْرُ وَإِن تَشْكُرُوا يَرْضَهُ لَكُمْ. This is an important verse, inshallah, in this respect, 39. Verse 7, if you disbelieve, surely Allah does not need you. He likes not disbelief for His slaves. And if you are grateful, this pleases Him. Those who do good deeds, Allah is pleased with them. He is angry with those who deserve His anger. رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه ذلك لمن خشي ربه. As in, Allah is well pleased with them, meaning the companions of the Prophet ﷺ, and they are well pleased with him. That is for him who fears Allah, his Rabb. And as for the hypocrites, look at this in contrast. Look at this in Surah Al-Fath, Quran 48:6, and that He will punish the munafiqeen, the hypocrites, men and women, and the mushriks, those who join partners with Allah, men and women, who think evil thoughts about Allah. For them is a disgraceful torment, and Allah is angry with them. Allah is angry with them. Allah is angry with them. He has cursed them and prepared hell for them, and worst indeed is that destination, meaning if they die on that state. Also, look at this in Surah An-Naml, Quran 16. من شرح بالكفر صدرا فعليهم غضب من الله ولهم عذاب عظيم. But those who open their breasts to disbelief, on them is Allah's wrath, and they shall have a severe torment. Now we'll put it in a nutshell concerning the will of Allah as follows. This is in summary. This is the take-home message with respect to the will of Allah. We know that the pre-decree is divided, has four ranks to it: the knowledge of Allah, the writing of Allah, thirdly the mashi'a, this is which we are talking about, the will of Allah. In summary, therefore, the will of Allah is the prerequisite for bringing forth every existing thing. If Allah the Exalted does not will any matter, then His will entails the inevitable non-existence of that matter. It will never occur. His will covers everything from people, actions, moves, stillness, etc. Nothing in his kingdom takes a place without his leave, and nothing that he wills except that it will take place, although they may exist in his kingdom what he dislikes. You see, there may exist in his kingdom what Allah described, but he willed it to pass. He allowed such things to be carried out. If he wills to bring forth what he likes, he would do so. None can stop what Allah wants, and that his will is universal as well as legal. And his will is always linked to the wisdom and knowledge and justice of Allah. This is in summary the rank on Mashi'a, and we will move inshallah after 10 minutes. Yeah, she's crying there with her brothers and sisters. I don't know. Now she's coming to me, I think. I'm in trouble. We'll move inshallah shortly to the creation, the fourth rank. So I'll be back inshallah in 10 minutes, and I will put the recitation of the Quran, and inshallah I'll be back. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.